Hi, I'm Adam and welcome to First Man Photography. Today we're going to be talking about everything you need to know to start printing your pictures right now, today. Whether you're using a lab or you're doing it yourself at home, I've got some tips that are really going to help you out to really get the best out of your prints. I've also got a little offer for you a little bit later on in the video. There's lots to talk about, so let's go. I would like to go there at the back of the house. Where a high school teacher caught us when making out. You and me, perfect strangers, but really not at the same time. Nothing can come between us. You and me, we're staying alive. Alive, forever alive. So hear me out. I absolutely love printing my images, and it's just that final stage in creating an image, and it really, really brings your work to life. I genuinely believe that photography is an art, and when you print a picture out and you physically hold it in your hand, it's really difficult to argue with that. It definitely is an art, and it is a piece of artwork that you are then holding. You can just see the amount of work that's gone into it, the feel of it, the time it took to drive there, the color, the shape, everything about the image is there for everyone to see, and it's just a beautiful thing. It's a little bit like driving a really nice car. You drive it every day, it works well, you enjoy it, some people notice you, some people don't, and that's a bit like having your images on a digital screen. But every now and again, when the sun comes out, you're driving down that great, awesome coastal road with a beautiful girl sat next to you, rolling with the top down. It's just magical. It's an epic moment. And that's a little bit like the feeling you get when you print your picture out. Everybody is going to notice you, and everyone will notice a piece of printed work, and it invokes that same kind of feeling. So with that picture in your mind, if you haven't printed your work before, you really, really must. You won't regret it. However, to reproduce your images accurately from what you see on the screen to when you get them onto paper, there are a few things that you need to know, a few little details to go through to get that nice print. This applies to whether you're using a photo lab or you're printing at home, but it'll really help you avoid disappointment and really help your images pop. I'm going to assume that you're using Adobe Lightroom. If you're not, this also applies to other photo editors and stuff, but I really do recommend Adobe Lightroom. I'll put a link down below for you to get a free trial if you haven't tried it out before. So we're into Lightroom, and once you have finished editing your image, the first thing to do is to create a virtual copy. And that virtual copy is going to become our print file. The reason we want to have a special print file is because we want to increase the exposure a little bit between a quarter and half of a stop. And what that does is just increase that brightness in your image a little bit to compensate for the loss of the backlight, because when you look at them on the screen, they are backlit by the monitor, and when you remove that backlight in the print, sometimes it can look a bit dull and disappointing if you don't just nudge that exposure up a little bit. So it's a really nice way just to balance out the brightness in the final print to look more like it does on the screen. That's the first step. Now, if you're printing yourself, you can just go ahead and print that directly from your Lightroom using the RAW file. But if you're going to use a lab, they're not going to be able to read your RAW file with your adjustments. So what we need to do is export an image file for them to upload to their website so they can print that out. Most good labs will accept TIFF files. They're the higher quality files that don't lose any detail out of the image that JPEGs sometimes can. So make sure you export as a TIFF file. Now that brings us on to the lab versus DIY. Do you want to use a lab, a print lab, or are you going to print at home by yourself? There are upsides and downsides to both of them. Most of the time now, I print myself at home. I've got this Canon here, this Pro 10S. It's a really great printer and prints out images that are of equal quality to the sort of thing you get from a lab. It is expensive though, that's the downside, and it can work out with the ink and the paper and buying the printer itself. It can work out quite expensive depending on how many images you're creating or if you're selling them. It needs to be right for you. The other option is the lab, and using a lab is probably more versatile because you can use a full range of papers, you can use a full range of sizes because that only goes up to A3+. If you want A2, you need a more expensive printer, but at a lab, you can arrange that. They use roll paper, so you can get nice long images as well. You can use different types of materials. I get my water drop photos printed on this metal, and they just look absolutely fantastic, especially when you order them a meter by 1 meter square. These look fantastic on this aluminium metal, and it's a really, really interesting way to print. The downside of a lab is that you're not totally in control. Sometimes you'll get an image back from the lab, it won't be quite right, the person who's printed it won't have been taking much care, and you're just left a little bit disappointed. That doesn't happen very often if you use really good labs. I used to use one called the Print Space, and they have a full range of papers and sizes, and they're really good. They're not the cheapest, but they are really good. I'll put a link down below. So color accuracy is a really important thing for most of us when we're printing. If you have a beautiful sunset with orange and pink skies, when you print it out, you don't want that to come out really green. You want to have color as accurate as possible. And whether we're doing it in a lab or whether we're doing it at home, the way to get around this is to use an ICC profile. What that is a little profile that fits in with Lightroom, and it is a combination of your printer and the type of paper you're using. All good labs will let you download ICC profiles for free for the different types of paper, and the same applies if you're printing at home. The paper companies should provide ICC profiles for your printer. We then go into Lightroom, and if you go into the develop module, you can click on soft proofing and select the type of paper or printer that you're using, and then it will do its best to simulate what the final print will look like. It will save you time, and it will save you wasting money by getting poor prints. So soft proofing and ICC profiles are really a good tool to use to get color accuracy. Once we have applied our ICC profiles and we've made any adjustments that we want for the final print, you're pretty much ready to print. Apart from deciding which type of paper you are going to use, and the different types of paper can have a massive effect on your final image. You basically got three types. You've got glossy, semi-gloss, and matte. Now, they all do different things, and it's a bit subjective. As a general rule, I will use glossy for the big, colorful, saturated images. Images like this one here with loads of color in it all over the image, and it just, the glossiness really makes the colors pop in the image. Same is true for my water drop images. That's on glossy paper, and it's all about the color of these water drop images, and it just looks absolutely fantastic on this glossy paper. Semi-gloss is the next thing, and there are a few different names for semi-gloss. Some papers will be Barita or Luster. The paper is probably my favorite one, actually, is the semi-gloss, and I've been using Canson Barita Photographique for a long, long time. Is that what it's called? I think that's what it's called. They've got such different names, but it's just a beautiful, beautiful paper. It has a really professional, high-grade feel to it, and just makes images look incredible. And I use it for most of my landscape prints that I sell. Absolutely fantastic paper. I think that's one of my favorites out there. Now, matte is the third one. That doesn't have any glossiness on it at all, obviously. And matte papers, the good ones to use are your sort of cotton rag papers. They're high quality, sort of archival papers that hold lots of black in them. And when you hear about D-Max rating for a paper, that's about how much black it will hold. And matte cotton rag papers do that really well. Because of that, they work beautifully for black and white images, particularly portraits and things like that. There's a wedding picture there, and they just make that image so contrasty and nice, and it just works really well for black and white images. The same is true for black and white landscapes like this one that I took in Whitby not so long ago. And it's just, there's so much detail in there, and you can feel it. It just feels really nice as well. That's another thing about these cotton rag papers. This one is a cotton rag with an etching, so it's got a slight texture to it. That works well when you've got sort of smooth areas. It just adds a little bit of texture from the paper into the image, and I just think that works really nicely. It's very much a subjective thing, the type of paper you use for the type of image, and it'll come from a bit of experimentation on your behalf. You can use the rag paper for color images as well, ones like this long exposure seascape. It's got the nice sort of muted colors in there, and just overall creates a bit more of a sort of fine art feel to the overall image. And it's just, again, it just feels beautiful. It looks beautiful. And once it's in a frame, it's just absolutely magical. Recently, a company called PhotoSpeed got in touch with me and asked me if they could send me some of their papers to try out. And I said, sure, of course you can, as long as you do something for my subscribers. So what they've done is, for you, they've given you 10% off your first purchase. So all you need to do is go to photospeed.com, and then when you come to complete your purchase, put the voucher code FIRSTMAN10 in there, and then you'll get 10% off. PhotoSpeed are a good company. They've got great customer service. They sell all the best paper from the best manufacturers, but they also create paper of their own, which is pretty much to the similar sort of quality as those sort of traditional paper manufacturers. It's also significantly cheaper, their own brand stuff as well, and still gets great results. One of the reasons I agreed to do it though is because PhotoSpeed produced this pretty unique panoramic paper. Panoramas do not look good on the screen. They're just thin and don't fit onto a screen naturally. So really your only option is to print them out. And this paper makes that doable at home really. Whereas before you'd have to use a lab with a roll paper, but this now lets you do it at home. And the beauty of this paper as well is that it will fit into pretty much most A4 printers. So you don't need a big one like this. As long as you can put a custom size in, you will be able to use this paper in your A4 photo printer. I would recommend that you get this here. This is the test pack for the panorama pictures. Turn it right around. This is PhotoSpeed's test pack of panorama paper. It's got 6 different types of paper in it, and you get 4 copies of each paper. So it's a really nice thing to experiment with and try out the different papers. I particularly like the gloss, which is that one there, which you've seen, and the Barita as well, which is down here somewhere. That's one I took in the Lake District quite recently, and it's just, again, it has that really high quality feel of a Barita paper and just looks incredible. And yeah, I just absolutely love it. Great paper, really interesting on the sort of panoramic paper that you can use at home. 10% off photospeed.com and put FIRSTMAN10 in when you come to check out. So we're pretty much there now. It's a massive topic, so if you have any questions, please do ask them down below in the comments. So one more thing before we go. I get quite a lot of questions about the border on a print, the white border. Why would you print a white border around the image? Well, I will generally try and print borderless as much as I can. So things like this one here is borderless, because once you put it into a mount and into a frame, it still has the white mount as a border. But with printers, not all printers will print borderless. With this printer here, the Canon Pro XS, it won't print borderless with all types of paper, including this sort of thick photo rag paper. It also doesn't print borderless with custom sizes like the panoramic ones. But sometimes some people do want to have a border and will do it on purpose. It lets you put the little footer in at the bottom there, which can be quite handy if you want to put some information on there. And some people like the double border. It also makes it easier to handle without actually touching the picture itself. You can just sort of hold the edges a bit easier. But on the whole, I prefer borderless printing. Once you put it into a mount, it just adds that extra bit of real estate to the image and maximizes the paper overall. Anyway, head over to my website to check out all the prints I currently have for sale. I really recommend you look at the water drop prints and the metal prints. I'm really, really proud of those. I'd be honored if you were to buy one, and it really would help to keep the lights on as well. But I hope you've enjoyed this video and found it useful. I'll see you on another one very, very soon. I missed last week again because I was just so busy. I was filming a commercial video. I was embedded with the Royal Navy and a charity, doing some charity work. So I'm hoping I can, once I put that video together, I can share that story with you. But I will see you on another one very, very soon. I'm off out and about again next week. I'm Adam. This is First Man Photography. Out.